Okay, we've seen that in many cases, computing a limit at infinity involves a race. You've got one function that's growing, and another function that's growing, and you wonder which one grows the fastest. So, if this is growing, but this is f, if g is growing and f is growing faster, the limit might be infinity or minus infinity. If f is growing, but g is growing faster, the limit's going to be zero. If they're growing at the same rate, then the limit is probably going to be a non-zero number. So, for example, we saw that if you have a polynomial, that this is going to be 3/5, because you cancel a factor of x cubed from the top and the bottom, and all of these other terms, the x squared terms, the x terms, the constant terms, don't really matter, because once you divide by x cubed, they're things that are going to zero. On the other hand, if you want the limit as x approaches infinity of 3x cubed plus stuff divided by 5x squared plus stuff, now the top beats the bottom. 3 factors of x beat 2 factors of x, and so this is going to be infinity. But if you have the limit of 3x squared plus stuff divided by 5x cubed, then the bottom is growing faster. After you cancel out the x squareds, you get the limit of 3 plus stuff over 5x plus stuff, and that's going to be 0. So it's all a matter of a race. What's growing the fastest? So one thing that's pretty obvious is that x is slower than x squared. X squared is slower than x cubed, and so on. The more powers you have, the better. But it's not just powers. You also have exponentials, and you also have logs. So the basic rule is logs grow the slowest, then powers grow faster than logs, and exponentials grow fastest of all. So if I gave you a limit as x goes to infinity of natural log of x plus x to the 175th plus e to the x, let's say 2 e to the x, over x to the 3 million plus 5 e to the x, you'd say, you know, these are all going to infinity, but the thing that's growing the fastest is the e to the x term. Exponentials grow faster than powers, that grow faster than logs. So for purposes of figuring out our limits, it's the biggest terms that have the biggest effect. So this is going to wind up being 2/5. Now, you got to be careful because sometimes what happens as you go to infinity or what happens as you go to minus infinity is different. If I want the limit as x goes to infinity of 1 plus e to the x over 1 plus 2 e to the x, that's going to be 1/2, because as you go to infinity, the exponential is growing, and the 1 is negligibly small compared to the e to the x, and you just get 1/2. On the other hand, if I want the limit as x goes to minus infinity of 1 plus e to the x over 1 plus 2 e to the x, now this isn't growing exponentially, it's shrinking exponentially. You plug in a large negative number and e to a negative power is tiny. So you get something close to 1 divided by something close to 1. Now it's the 1 that's bigger. So in comparing these races, I really should say logs grow slower than positive powers, which grow slower than positive exponentials. That is, e to a positive number grows, e to a negative number shrinks. And that's it. That determines the race, and that determines which is the most important term for you to look at in terms of evaluating these limits. Now, why do these grow like this? We'll eventually get L'Hôpital's rule, which will justify these statements, but for now, they're useful rules of thumb.